The Honor 9 costs just 380 quid here in the UK, yet it seems to rock the same dual lens snapper as Huawei's P10 flagship phone. Here's a full Honor 9 camera review. When you open up the Honor 9's camera app, you're once again presented with a feature-dense interface, complete with many toggles on the main screen. This means you can add filters, turn on the obligatory beauty mode, toggle the flash, and activate Huawei's rather good wide aperture and portrait mode features. Actually, that portrait mode is an addition to the Honor lineup previously only found on the Huawei P10 and P10 Plus. Like the wide aperture mode, this helps your subject to stand out against the background, using the likes of bokeh effects as well as some weird color manipulation. Another addition here is the move and pictures mode. When enabled, this apparently captures a second of video before and after your photo was taken to bring them to life in your gallery, kind of like the Live in Images feature found on the recent iPhones. However, I found that moving pictures only seem to capture a slice of the footage before each photo, at least that's how it seems when flicking through the Honor 9's gallery. You get a brief burst of animation before the subject suddenly leaps ahead in time. It's slightly disorienting and not quite as smooth a transition as you get on the iPhone. Note also that you can't have the move in pictures mode and the wide aperture or portrait mode activated at the same time. Tap the shutter button and the nippy autofocus gets to work, capturing your snap almost instantly, as long as the lighting conditions are alright. You also get full manual controls to get a very exact shot. To access these, you just need to swipe right into the main Honor 9 camera features menu. In there, you'll also find plenty of other camera modes. For instance, you can take a panorama, get funky with the light painting feature, shoot a time lapse and slow motion footage, and so on. It's not really any kind of surprise that the Honor 9 captures nice, clear, detailed photos in good light. Those two lenses work together to produce detailed images, complete with accurate colour reproduction. Shutter speed is pretty quick as well, so subjects in motion are cleanly captured in most cases, with very little blur to speak of. Macro shots are just as impressive. Getting close to your subject and the lens doesn't struggle, reliably capturing even tiny details in a crisp and clear fashion. High contrast shots are generally well produced too. Shoot against a bright sky and you can expect some oversaturation of said sky, while finer details are lost in other parts of the photos. However, compared to other similarly priced phones such as the OnePlus 5, the Honor 9 holds up admirably, and you can always tweak stuff like the brightness using those pro controls when needed. However, the Honor 9 really does struggle compared with its peers when it comes to low light shots. Try capturing a photo in dim light and you'll have no choice but to fire up that flash, or else your snap will be marred with some ugly grain. You do get a night mode, which basically offers a super long exposure to brighten things up, but it's completely useless without some kind of tripod to keep the phone perfectly still. The wide aperture mode and portrait mode do their thing as you'd expect, blurring the background while keeping your subject nice and sharp. It's not really much different to the effect you get on the single lens Samsung Galaxy S8, however, with its depth of field cheat mode activated. The Honor 9's camera offers a pretty respectable performance when it comes to video capture too, although it's definitely not quite perfect. Quality levels are decent on the default mode of full HD resolution, 30 frames per second capture. Detail is sharp enough to make your test footage look respectable when enjoyed on a full-size TV. And you also get some nice digital image stabilization, which effectively reduces the tremble and tremors when you're moving and shooting at the same time. You'll only notice the slight sudden vibration with every step that you take. However, jack up to 60 frames per second or 4K resolution, and that stabilizer feature is immediately disabled. This means walking and filming is a very bad idea, as you'll get a lot of shake. Still, at 60 frames per second, the resulting video is pleasingly smooth, while our Ultra HD footage was packed with detail. The Honor 9 also offers full manual controls for your video recording, so you can tweak the lights and white balance while shooting. That's something rarely found on mobile, so should definitely be applauded. Note the 4K video samples on the Honor 9 are shot in the HEVC format, which compresses the file size so it takes up a lot less space on your phone's storage, without any real impact on quality, thankfully. This is great news if you shoot a lot of video, and that does mean that uploading to YouTube directly is a no-no. You'll need a program such as Handbrake to convert the video file before doing so. For a full Honor 9 camera review, check out recombo.com/mobile, and don't forget to subscribe to the Recombo YouTube channel.